house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing a psalm to his name, for he is loving. For the Lord has chosen Jacob for himself, and Israel for his own possession.
For I know the Lord is great, that our Lord is high above all gods. The Lord does whatever he wills, in heaven, on earth, in the seas.
He summons clouds from the ends of the earth, make lightning produce the rain, make his treasuries, he sent forth the wind.
The firstborn of the Egyptians he smote, of man and beast alike. Signs and wonders he worked in the midst of your land, O Egypt, against Pharaoh and all his servants.
Nation in their greatness he struck, and kings in their splendor he slew. Sihon, king of the Amorites, Og, the king of Bashan, and all the kingdom of Canaan. He let Israel inherit their land, on his people their land he bestowed.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Great is the Lord our God, transcending all other gods. House of Israel, bless the Lord. Sing psalms to him, for he is merciful.
Lord, your name stands forever, unforgotten from age to age. For the Lord does justice for his people. The Lord takes pity on his servants.
Pagan idols are silver and gold, the work of human hands. They have mouths, but they cannot speak. They have eyes, but they cannot see.
They have ears, but they cannot hear. There is never a breath on their lips. Their makers will come to be like them, and so will all who trust in them.
Sons of Israel, bless the Lord. Sons of Aaron, bless the Lord. Sons of Levi, bless the Lord. You who fear him, bless the Lord.
From Zion, may the Lord be blessed, he who dwells in Jerusalem.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Father, your name and your memory last forever. We stand to pray in your house and praise you with psalms of joy. We ask you in your kindness to have mercy on us in our lowliness. House of Israel, bless the Lord. Sing psalms to him, for he is merciful. All nations will come and worship before you, O Lord. Mighty and wonderful are your works, Lord God Almighty. Righteous and true are your ways, O King of the nations.
Who would dare refuse you honor or the glory due your name, O Lord?
Since you alone are holy, all nations shall come and worship in your presence. Your mighty deeds are clearly seen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginnings, now and will be forever. Amen. All nations will come and worship before you, O Lord. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. We know that God makes all things work together for the good of those who have been called according to his decree. Those whom he foreknew, he predestined to share the image of his Son, that the Son might be the firstborn of many brothers. Those he predestined, he likewise called. Those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he in turn glorified. The Lord has chosen her, his loved one, from the beginning.
The Lord has chosen her, his loved one, from the beginning.
He has taken her to live with him.
His loved one from the beginning.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord has chosen her, his loved one from the beginning.
Please stand for the Canticle of Mary. You have left everything to follow me. You will have it all returned 100-fold and will inherit eternal life. Alleluia. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has
mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy. The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and will be forever. Amen. You have left everything to follow me. You will have it all returned 100-fold and will inherit eternal life. The intercession of holy women, let us pray for the church in these words. Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Through all the women martyrs who conquered bodily death by their courage, strengthen your church in the hour of trial.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Through married women who have advanced in grace by holy matrimony, make the apostolic mission and your church fruitful.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Through widows who ease their loneliness and sanctify it by prayer and hospitality, help your church reveal the mystery of your love to the world.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Through mothers who have borne children for the kingdom of God and the human community, help your church bring all men and women to a rebirth in life and salvation.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Through all your holy women who have been worthy to contemplate the light of your countenance, let the deceased members of your church exalt in that same vision forever.
Be mindful of your church, Lord.
Now let us pray as Christ the Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
God our Father, every year you give us joy in this feast of Saint Chantal. As we honor her memory by this celebration, may we follow the example of her holy life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. May the Lord bless us, protect us all from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
The Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Oratio Imperata. Altogether, merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins, and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to you in our need, to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsod.
Pray for us.
Saint James the Great.
Pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. The Holy Mass shall begin shortly. Good afternoon. Welcome to the celebration of the Holy Eucharist on this Friday of the 19th week in Ordinary Time. Today is also the seventh day of the Novena in honor of the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And the theme is forgiveness. Day 7 is Mary at the foot of the cross. How deep is the pain of a mother watching her son go through so much agony and suffering as she saw him scourged, crowned with thorns, mocked, and finally crucified. And what might be had felt for the killers of her son. Yet, Mary stood bravely at the foot of the cross. She continued to ponder and kept all these things in her heart. This was the final detachment. In our human eyes, this is extremely difficult to accept. But in Mary's eyes, she understood that this was the Father's will and that her son's mission was now complete. And this is where Mary finds joy. It is with this joyful detachment that probably allowed Mary to forgive all those who caused the death of her son. Forgiveness is joyful detachment. Please stand to welcome our presiding priest, Father Joseph Landero.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, make known to Jerusalem her abomination. Thus says the Lord God to Jerusalem, by origin and birth, you are of the land of Canaan. Your father was an Amorite, and your mother is a Hittite. As for your birth, the day you were born, your navel cord was not cut. You were neither washed with water, nor anointed, nor were you rubbed with salt, nor swathed in swaddling clothes. No one looked on you with pity or compassion to do any of these things for you. Rather, you were thrown out on the ground as something loathsome the day you were born. Then I passed by and saw your weltering in your blood. I said to you, live in your blood and grow like a plant in the field. You grew and developed. You came to the age of puberty. Your breasts were formed. Your hair had grown, but you were still stark naked. Again, I passed by you and saw that you were now old enough for love. So I spread the corner of my cloak over you to cover your nakedness. I swore an oath to you and entered into a covenant with you. You became mine, says the Lord God. Then I bathed you with water, washed away your blood, and anointed you with oil. I clothed you with an embroidered gown, put sandals of fine leather on your feet. I gave you a fine linen sash and silk robes to wear. I adorn you with jewelry. I put bracelets on your arms, a necklace about your neck, a ring in your nose, pendants in your ears, and a glorious diadem upon your head. Thus you were adorned with gold and silver. Your garments were of fine linen, silk, and embroidered cloth. Fine flour, honey, and oil were your food. You were exceedingly beautiful, with the dignity of a queen. You were renowned among the nations for your beauty, perfect as it was, because of my splendor, which I had bestowed on you, says the Lord God. But you were captivated by your own beauty. You used your renown to make yourself a harlot, and you lavished your harlotry on every passerby whose own you became. Yet I will remember the covenant I made with you when you were a girl, and I will set up an everlasting covenant with you, that you may remember and be covered with confusion, and that you may be utterly silenced for shame when I pardon you for all you have done, says the Lord God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You have turned from your anger.
Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim his name. Among the nations make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name.
You have turned from your anger.
Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, For great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
You have turned from your anger.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Receive the word of God, not as the word of men, but as it truly is, the word of God. Alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees approached Jesus and tested him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause whatever?" He said in reply, "Have you not read that from the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, 'For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.' So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must not separate." They said to him, "Then why did Moses command that the man give the woman a bill of divorce and dismiss her?" He said to them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, Moses allowed you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning, it was not so. I say to you, whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery." His disciples said to him, "If that is the case of a man with his wife, it is better not to marry." He answered, "Not all can accept this word, but only those to whom that is granted. Some are incapable of marriage because they were born so, some because they were made so by others, some because they have renounced marriage for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. Whoever can accept this ought to accept it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In our Gospel today, we are reminded about the sacredness of marriage, which is a sacrament. That years after, when there would be problems, Jesus made it clear that divorce is unacceptable. Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery. And so when Jesus was asked, why is it that Moses allowed? And the answer of Jesus, because of the hardness of man's heart. Moses allowed you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning, it was not so. If we go back to God's original plan, it is not that way. But we realize as years go by, people change. I also saw this with my own parents. 4 years ago, I celebrated their golden wedding anniversary. And I knew it was not easy for them to reach that far. Nung tinanong ko po sila sa golden wedding, "Nanay, tatay," in front of the community, "how do you describe your relationship for the past 50 years? Yung mother ko, bilis, sumagot agad. Sabi niya, "Para kaming sweet and sour." And then, bago makapagsalita, tatay ko, tinuro niya, sabi niya, "Siya yung sour, ako yung sweet." Hindi makasagot yung father ko. But just to show to you, it was not easy. There was a time they almost separated because of distance, because of work. And my father had to make a sacrifice because I think the element of sacrifice is necessary so that the union can be brought to its maturity. And we know that One of the purposes of marriage is union. It's not only spiritual union, but also emotional union, because marriage is the beginning of the family, and it is a lifelong commitment. So it also provides an opportunity to grow in selflessness with a lot of sacrifices. As husband and wife, they serve one another and their children, the family. Yun din po nakita ko. Merong give and take, merong times yung partner ang magpapakumbaba, hindi mo sasabayan ang init ng ulo kung mainit na yung ulo ng isa. And that's why I said, I admired my parents. I told them because I knew when one day they almost broke up. Yun yung time na hindi ko gustong maalala. Elementary pa lang kami. Naglipara na yung mga plato, kutsara, tinidor dahil sa matinding away. But because of God's grace and their willingness to make sacrifices for each other, to humble themselves, to accept one's sin or failures and the other to be willing to forgive, umabot sila ng 50 years sa kanilang golden, which they thought they could not achieve. But with God's grace, they were able to reach. Let's pray for couples who are on the verge of breaking up, or couples who are having problems, couples who are here, couples we know who need our prayers, so that they will all be willing to make that sacrifice and the union that is there will be maintained. Because I always believe a great marriage does not just happen because of the love that they had in the beginning, but it is how well couples continue building that love every day until the end. Intercessions. Husbands and wives share in God's creation of new life. Our intercessions today center around the needs of couples, parents, children, and family. Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
The church may effectively teach its members the true dignity of marriage and help couples to stay together in their sacred calling. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with love, O Lord.
That government leaders and legislators may enact laws and policies that build families rather than destroy them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with love, O Lord.
That families broken by divorce or separation may find support and understanding from people in their communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
That those experiencing difficulties in their marriage may receive the grace to persevere in their commitments. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
That deceased relatives and friends may have the joy and peace in God's eternal home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
In silence, let us pray for personal intentions, the Mass intentions for today, and those that have asked us to pray for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill our homes with your love, O Lord.
God of love, you created us male and female to continue your work of creation. May our love for one another reflect your indwelling presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this bread we offer, fruit of the earth, work of our hands, it will become the bread of life.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O Lord, be pleased to accept the offerings of your Church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, was to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jesse, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now pray. Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. O Lord, may the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We now pray for the prayer for the day 7 of our novena to the solemnity of Our Lady's Assumption. Altogether, relying on your own might or power, it will be impossible to forgive. So let us beg God for the grace to let go of our pride and our resentment and forgive the persons who have done us wrong. Let our prayer be, in the name of Jesus, my Lord, for the love of my Jesus, my Lord, I forgive you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of the Assumption, pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Siyang